chain. So my name is Kamil Rytarowski. I'm a NetBSD developer, and I move on. I started to use NetBSD since the version 6.1. It's quite recent to other people, to other developers. And I'm a quite fresh developer in the project. I'm mostly focused on the kernel part, user land, and packet source. And my main point, my main focus is to use NetBSD as a desktop. In recent times, on the laptop and as a workstation. At the current time, I'm an LLVM committer. This involves also committing to other LLVM projects like Clang, LLDB, compiler RT, Poly, and others. I'm also a GDB GNU GDB and GNU BNewTils committer. Also, we focus for NetBSD part, and I became recently a NetBSD maintainer in the QEMU project. At the moment, I focus on compatibility with NetBSD as host. I have streamed all the local patches, and we are passing all the tests in the test suite in QEMU. And I'm helping other projects that are using packet source to upstream the patches. So we move to LLDB. So there's some blinking. I will focus on the LLDB part and my presentation. I will start with some elementary terminology to make clear. Okay, so we start with elementary terminology to make clear what am I talking about and what's my work about. And I will talk about LLDB porting details. And at the end, I will note some progress about sanitizers. They are also part of the LLVM toolchain. And I will end my talk with the list of current tasks, some roadmap that is evolution. So I wanted to tell clearly that a debugger is not just some kind of third-party optional software on. In that case, on a Unix operating system. However, it's integral part and traditional integral part of Unix toolchain. It's as important as a compiler, linker, libraries like libc, libpthread for threads, and more advanced toolchains can contain also additional software like 3D graphics modeling, audio software, and similar. Here's a picture of an example debugger. It's DDD, a fronted to GDB. And I'm defining here what's the debugger in my meaning, in my use case. It's a computer program that can trace other process. And it's the approach is about stopping the program on certain kinds of traps and investigate the traced program. And there are also other kinds of debuggers like null that don't involve stopping the process like dtrace and or ktrace for kernel syscall tracing and similar events from the kernel. They are also kind of debuggers. However, I focus on the debugger that it's using ptrace API, that it's using the approach of stopping the process and giving ability to a programmer to investigate the current state. So yes, I'm describing a usual workflow of using a debugger to find and fix a bug. So we try to reproduce an issue, isolate the issue to like one library or one module, one function. We are looking, we are trying to detect the source of the issue. And we are attempting to remove the reason of the bug. And at the moment, at the end, verify that the problem is gone. It looks so, it looks very simple from big picture. However, in case of large software, it's more complicated, but because we have context of functionality that may be slightly altered by our bug fix. And I also note that I recall a research from Bell Labs about telecom software bugs. There was research that scientists were looking for, trying to understand what's the most common source of new, of introduction of new bugs in software. And the results said that fixing old bugs is the most common source of new bugs. So it's less trivial in the context of software. So it's not just about fixing one bug and we are done. We need to verify that it's, everything is still working. There are no regressions. Nobody's complaining, and the problem is gone. Here is an example session of GDB debugger that we set a breakpoint on a function named fun3. We start the debugger. We see that the program has stopped here, and we can investigate trace of function calls. And this is the view of a traditional debugger like GDB or LLDB from a programmer or end user point of view. And to get such picture, we need to investigate registers of functions, of threads, stopped threads, to retrieve at least stack pointer, code pointer. When we retrieve code pointer, we can check what are the functions next or before the interruption. With stack pointer register, we can investigate backtrace. This is a simplified point of view, but it is more or less about this. And to improve the usability of a debugger, we need debug symbols. And for programs, it means additional information that can help to navigate the code line by line or variable by variable. And also this require this mandates support for such language, original language of the traced program in the debugger, like C, C++, or Fortran. At the moment in LLDB, there is support for Clang languages, like C, C++, Objective-C, I think Objective-C++, Swift, .NET, but there are also plugins in external sources. And so we have an example program, Hello World. And to create debug information, we need to use a G option in a GCC compatible compilator driver. It means that we want to add append debug information, and we need to lower optimization options, like OG means that we want to get some optimization that is still usable to trace the program. So here are examples of two computer programs, one computer program and one core file. And I'm using a file utility to describe the compiled program for NetBSD. There is a note about debug info that it's attached. It means that we are using G option to GCC, and it's not stripped. Not stripped, it means that we can also, after the compilation, strip symbols and strip some ELF tables to make the final executable very small, yes. And there are also core files. Core files are, in fact, they are images of processes. And when, in usual case, when a program is crashing, we can order the operating system, instruct the operating system to stop the process and save its memory, save its state, information about the process, and create a core file. And later we can open the core file and investigate the current state of the process. We can in very details. And yes, LLDB is built, is quite recent debugger, recent software. GDB is a very old project. It has support for many operating systems that are in extinct. I think little people develop today for maybe HP, UX, Unix systems, and they need still to support such operating system in such debuggers. And old Unix systems had very primitive debugging API for the kernel, and it was not evolving to add more precise, more recent features, to use better hardware, better get better performance, better correctness, and the development was stagnant for such platforms. And LLDB is pushing for as modern capabilities of operating systems as possible. In fact, it's at the moment pushing for Linux level or Darwin, Windows, FreeBSD level of API features. And yes, this is what I told, that we need very, very modern API, modern compiler with C++ 11 version and beyond that, and kernel introspection, modern functions, yes. And this enforced me to work on catching up after the competitors with feature parity in the ptrace system call. And we are already there with machine-dependent parts and in the number of system calls or in the set of functionality. We are still not there with machine-dependent parts. For example, we don't have accessors for X-save, X-save opt registers on modern Intel CPUs to trace, for example, AlphaWix version 2 software that is using such instruction sets. At the moment, I don't find the machine-dependent parts as important to work on them now. It's scheduled for later. I'm focused on machine-dependent code, and later we can add, I hope, quite simply, all the machine-dependent parts when needed. Yes, so I got some list of goals. So yes, as I thought that this was the motivation to improve, revamp the ptrace syscall. And we have also many problems with GDB. I think this is common in other BSDs and other systems. and that, for example, threads are problematic in processes to trace them correctly. And indirectly working on ptrace for LLDB, I'm improving also DDB correctness. We are also heading for, there are also efforts to head for LLVM clean base system to replace the GNU toolchain parse as an option. So when possible, people can take a GNU toolchain base system or LLVM base system toolchain. And we are still looking for LLD, so the LLVM linker porter. It quite works from basic things, however, it needs more time of dedicated developer to get some our specific or generic specific needs to get it them right and usable for to at least build the base system and packet source software, yes. And also that there's indirect positive effect on support for dtrace and or KGDB in future. For example, dtrace has option to trace kernel code or user space code. And for user space code, they are using ptrace for some operations. For example, they put a trap on the entry of a syscall. They check whether this syscall is fork. If so, they remove all breakpoints, software breakpoints. They execute the fork and they put trap on the syscall exit and re-enable breakpoint traps. And this is a use case for dtrace. And indirectly, we improved the support for libproc library. Libproc is has origins in Illumos, Solaris operating system, because Illumos has approach to use to rather use proc file system, virtual file system, and trace through the system. However, programmers are more familiar with C API, so they have a wrapper for the proc file system, and the wrapper is called libproc, and for better compatibility with dtrace and compatibility with dtrace, the dtrace version on Solaris and BSDs, we maintain libproc that is wrapping ptrace calls in the BSD case. Yes, so as I thought, that there's no fight between toolchains. At least this is not my goal, not my motivations. We need both. Some tool, some software requires this, the other this. Yes. Yes, there are also some LLDB, direct LLDB benefits like visibility in the LLVM project, that we are alive and they are concerned about NetBSD support. I maintain, for example, NetBSD build bot in the LLVM Clang and LLDB project. They are obligated to not break it, yes. Sometimes they need some support like looking for the correct solution for BSD, NetBSD. Yes, and in the beginning, LLDB was developed for Linux and macOS, and these systems are very different in terms of kernel internals. And there was a lot called duplication, and we are working together with upstream, and it's also some kind of my effort to push common parts into common libraries. At the moment, we can share a lot of code with Linux and FreeBSD. Darwin is very different, Windows is very different, And we don't want too much, too many lines of NetBSD only code, because it can rot, yes. So I move on. So there was recently a release of LLVM 5.0. They are switching from 4.0 version to 5 now. They are also switching to new model of versioning the toolchain version. And so far I managed to get support for tracing one thread, processes with one thread, and on AMD 64 version of NetBSD. The version of 32-bit is also close, however, I have not been focused on this, but it shouldn't be very difficult. There are also some needs that we need to cross-build from 60-bit operating system to 32-bit, because LLDB requires too many RAM, too much RAM. Yes, it is a constraint, yes. And we can investigate core files. So core files were images of process that broke for some reason or was saved or saved by external tool. We have an in-base tool called G-Core. It can make an image of a process, and we can use investigators for some other purpose. LLDB is also pushing for client-server model. It means that we have server part that is directly tracing the process, and client part that is communicating with the server, and they are using the GDB remote serial protocol interface. Yes, it's standard from GDB. We can also use in theory GDB front end to LLDB back end and switch this, but I have not been trying this, but it shouldn't be difficult to get right. And this model is also is useful because we can put server on some underpowered machine where we don't want to have source code, object, debug code, and we just want to orchestrate a process and communicate everything through, for example, serial line or TCP IP stack to other computer. And we can use on more powerful computer front end with GUI, for example, and trace the process. There's also some need of the design of the Unix operating system, because the ptrace system call on Unix is using signals to report events about processes, about the process, and there is one usually there is one in the classical model that there's one signal handler, yes, per process. So, for example, if you want to have integrated GUI client with that is directly tracing a process, and so we have may have problems because GUI toolkits like Qt, for example, are using also internally in the libraries signal handlers, and they can conflict, and this is another reason for pushing for this model. And yes, and we support this model for NetBSD. There's also support for Linux with Android. Android is using is mostly Linux compatible. However, they are dropping some legacy interfaces to be compatible with old BSD version 4.3 API. because Linux is preserving this API. And this is the reason why we are quite similar between Linux and BSD. And we can also use the debugger for base system applications. We have our specific paths like usr, libdata, debug. It's different to Linux, FreeBSD, and perhaps other systems. They have Linux, usr, lib, debug with our data. And the debugger can detect the path, find debug information, debug files, and show needed data about the process. However, in the late process of preparing the 5.0 version of LLVM and LLDB, there was a window of perhaps 1 month when the debugger broke on NetBSD because of user space threads problems. This is still in investigation. I will talk about this a bit later. And also we have with local patches support for core files with multiple threads. And I can show presentation from April, how it used to work. This is a script that will play a film, kind of film, about LDB on NetBSD. Yes, this example with tracing core file with multiple threads on from NetBSD, something broke. Yes, this was recorded in April, in the late state of preparation for the LLVM version 5. And I got multiple threads to work on from NetBSD. So I'm presenting the version 5. There's the Firefox core. I need to also pass the location of Firefox binary. And it started. So I can list the threads. There are 16 threads. Most of them are busy waiting on something. And the thread one detected a signal segmentation fault. Yes. There's also support for internal GUI, something similar to GDB 2E. And it's loading. So we can go pass through the code and see variables, threads. And we can see where the crash happened. It was some assert. Is that we were dereferencing a null pointer. Most grass, yes, it's assert, yes. So, we can check local variables, the values. This code wasn't upstreamed because I had breakage of the interface for regular processes, and I delayed this to later. The support is in packet source work in progress repository. However, it should be rebased to newer version, I think. Yes, we can list the threads. And we can also check registers for every thread has the state of registers, so we can investigate them. We also can investigate floating point unit registers. It's called okay, so I will interrupt this and move back to the debugger. Okay. So the DROS package, so I will tell what's the impact on the base system of LLDB porting. There is a stack of LLDB is laying on the stack of Clang, LLVM, user and libraries, kernel and hardware. We can't do anything with the hardware. We can must use it as it is. And we can alter kernel when needed, improve it, design with user and libraries like libc, libthread, or C++ runtime library. The same with LLVM and Clang. And here's the impact on the kernel with the ptrace of the debugging interfaces. And, we need to deal with forks, vforks. You have the ptrace system call to trace the orchestrate the process. It's based on signals, so we need to wait system call. We are also interested in exec system call. This means that we are swapping the image of the process to other process. It's the unique design that we are forking and exec and changing the process to other process, yes. And we need to notify the debugger about the switch and load new debug symbols for new process. And that is supported now on NetBSD. We have also the proc file system. However, it's not used for the LLDB debugger. And we are slowly getting rid of this. We need this basically for Linux compatibility. There's also sysctl syscall to investigate generic information about the process. And it's not debugger specific. We also have machine independent parts inside cores and machine independent parts inside registers, yes, like floating point unit, debug registers. Base system impact is quite small, I think, hopefully. LLDB is not requiring a lot of libraries. We just need good libc, libthread, and correct C++ runtime library. We had problems with call once from C++. And this was affecting LLDB in general, and we had to fix this. So about LLVM Clang. So when I hit problems with the LLDB breakage, I decided to get the state of zero problems inside LLVM and Clang, and I started to work on test suite for LLVM and Clang, and get to near zero numbers of failures. There is still one ongoing effort on revamping the just-in-time API in LLVM to be compatible with PAX and Protect hardening on NetBSD, because we can't map in the same time writable memory and executable memory. We need to work around this, and it's best to we need to change the just-in-time library for this. And there, everything else is working correctly. So, as I noted, there is the ptrace system call that is used for tracing. And I was also already talking about this. It came from 80 and T Unix. It was adopted by BSD systems and by Linux. I will show about this later. And thanks to this, we can share a lot of ideas, use cases with Linux, and this is good for BSD. Yes, there's also sysctl system call that can investigate generic purpose, generic information about process, its threads, like name of the thread. It's generic information, not debugger specific, and we can use this CTL for this. It's also KVM, but at the moment it's not in use by LLDB. It will be used in future for KGDB porting. It's for reading kernel memory. So we have also some security constraints, like mProtect. Debugger must or should be able to place a trap, software trap, inside the process. And this means that the map page must be readable for a while. And we need to support this for debugger in the debugger use case. So when a process is ptracing other process, we are removing the restriction of no readable and executable memory, for example. And we also cannot trace every process. We need to be privileged. We also cannot trace processes out of Ceca root.
You're running out of time.
So just a moment. Okay, so I would note that ptrace is based about reparenting. We have parent process, child process, tracer, and there's a use case that we are swapping parent with tracer. And here is the evolution of ptrace. And there are some references for ptrace. And here's the list of new kernel features to host LLDB debugger and approaches. Yes, what's new in ptrace? I can share this after the talk in detail. Yes, I'm also maintaining the build bot for the ptrace system code. There are around 1,000 tests executed for MD64 port for just ptrace and surrounding like weight for debug registers and many use cases. And yes, I'm working mainly in a packet source work in progress. I put there my patches and I later upstream them to the LFM directory. Yes, I'm running LLDB buildbot. And I also work on sanitizer, but we skip this. Save stack, it was in the talk about hardening packet source and diffuser. There are some also bugs, task credits. Yes, so this is, I was also thinking how to finish my presentation. And I was inspired by the opening talk about heroes. So I took a phrase from Gnaeus Pompeius Magnus Minor. It means Minor is younger one. It means that that there was a history that there were domestic wars in Rome Empire, and soldiers were out of food, and they had to go through the sea and to Rome and get food for the soldiers, and Gnaeus told that it's not necessary to live on that side of the sea, but it's necessary to sail through storms, risk, and maybe win the battle, domestic war, and get the food. Yes, I think this is also applicable for NetBSD, that there are many storms, many problems, but we need to try to cross the sea and maybe win the war.
Anyone with questions?
Thanks for a nice presentation. But I was curious about the bit with package source hardening. You kind of glossed over them. If you could have a quick, just a quick summary would be great, because I'm quite curious about that.
Okay. The hardening part is more about safe stack, and our developer Pierre is working on introduction of hardening features to packet source, so we can build packages with, for example, in this particular case, with safe stack. Safe stack is based on two stacks. We have safe stack for safe operation and unsafe stack for possibly problematic operations. And we need LLVM support for this, and it was added within my work. And what to and the process of implementation of this is up to Pierre, and I think this can be finished for or done for LLVM version 6. So still we have some months to go.
More questions?
Quite simple question is why it's necessary to patch LLDB to support multithreading on NetBSD.
What was the problem, or?
Well, the question is, doesn't it support it out of the box? So why?
No. Yes. In the beginning, we had no support for multithreading in ptrace. It's also similar for OpenBSD currently. In old NetBSD version, we had a different model of threads. We had user space threads. It was based on the schedule activations, and we had a libp thread that was doing scheduling, and we had a special libp thread debug library, and we are trying to debug process through this library, and currently we have different model that one, that mapping of user space and kernel space threads is one-to-one, and we needed to introduce new API, not on the libp thread level, however, on the kernel level. So we can now start, suspend, and resume a dedicated or a dedicated thread from the debugger side. There are also other problems. We have, for example, a mistake, a design one design mistake from that is shared, for example, with Windows, that we are using the same internal kernel property about stopping or suspending the process like the pthread is using. Pthread is using syscall LWP suspend, and it's setting the same bit as debugger, so they can config one with the other, and in future I will add as dedicated bit for just debuggers. It will be invisible for other processes and for the process itself. And this is ongoing effort, and there are many bugs, stability bugs, and this is prolonging the work, and however, this is very needed to move forward. And before resuming my LDB user space work, I want to get kernel part for multiple threads done.
Thank you for your presentation.